It's the 10-year anniversary of the World Summit on the Information Society. The world gathered 10 years ago to think about how the world was transforming from an industrial to an information society and making sure that all of our people have access to the technologies necessary to fulfill their potential using ICTs. So we set a bunch of targets and a bunch of goals for ourselves, and now the assessment of how far we've come, how close we are to reaching those goals, and where we're falling short, what we need to do to come together as a world and make sure that we get to where we need to be. So a report has been compiled from many sources and all stakeholders to give an assessment of where we stand. And it is truly mind-boggling. I mean, the idea that we now have 3 billion people connected to the network over wireless technologies that we could not have imagined, the prominence of cloud computing and the depth to which ICTs have gone into the economy, including the Internet of Things and cloud computing, it really is just, it's just amazing. We would like to see an ambitious agenda, a realistic agenda, an aspirational agenda built on consensus, and the idea of really focusing, bringing back the focus to a people-centered information society. This isn't a government-centered information society, it's not a corporate-centered information society. We're here to serve people. And the degree to which the work we do enables human beings either to create or use technology to further their own human goals for development is our purpose and our mission.
In the US, we believe that building science and technology capacity is essential to solve challenges. The challenges that the world faces today are not just one country's responsibility. We have shared challenges, and we will only achieve those solutions if we collaborate. Today, what we are doing here builds towards knowledge-based economies. How do we build that capacity to have the knowledge that we need to solve problems? How do we power, promote our entrepreneurs and innovators so that they can create and their creations are protected? And how do we break down barriers for women and girls in science, technology, and innovation? We do that through our universities, but we also do that in entrepreneurship around the US through many initiatives, and we think that's essential for innovation of the future. As a woman scientist, I believe that what we are doing here today is crucial. Science, technology, and innovation are fundamental to any progress we make in solving development challenges and alleviating poverty. When we are talking about challenges like connectivity and empowering women, these are fundamentals. We need to provide the training, we need to provide the resources, and we need to open doors, not only for education, but also for them to attain leadership positions. So this is why this is really important. Countries around the world talking about these topics, it's really something that is very near and dear to my heart.